What happened that you happened to come to the hospital?
I was out riding my car with two other people, going down this hill, and all of a sudden it turned over. And I was arrested, of course, for that job. And they were going to turn me loose, except that they called in and said the Army had AWOL out on me, which is a lie, of course. But they arrested me there and took me here, under escort.
Why do you think they brought you to a psychiatric hospital?
Orders from somewhere else, I would assume.
Did you do anything that they might have misinterpreted as being, you know, something that you should have been brought to a psychiatric hospital?
Well, mostly fear is why they didn't want to hang on to me too long.
What were they afraid of?
Well, I'm an own killer. Where they come from, so well.
What do you mean?
It's a pretty touchy thing being around me if you're on the wrong side. They don't really have me holding me unless I'm inside a cage or something.
What do you mean that you're an own killer?
I have killed.
What do you mean? How many people have you killed?
Several hundred.
Where did you kill them?
Chicago, Detroit, New York, Mississippi Gulf, California, Texas.
Why did you kill them?
Because they were in the act of violent crimes.
Like what?
Like murder, rape, brutal beatings, extortion, illicit drug trafficking.
Did you kill them?
Yes.
To prevent them from doing that, or what?
Well, when it got back to the leaders, it did stop quite a few illegal events from happening.
What do you mean by their leaders?
Their highest in the land.
Are you talking about the Mafia or what?
Yes, indeed. Mafiosi, Cosa Nostra. They used to be the same, but no longer. They divided up in this nation, and a few from other nations that were stepping on the grounds for information gathering purposes.
What made you decide to take it into your own hands to do that?
I was the highest ranking official at the time.
Highest ranking official in what?
In intelligence.
Oh, so you work in intelligence?
Yes.
What were you doing when you were in the car that crashed?
I was enjoying myself by self-medicating myself with hashish.
And you were an intelligence officer then?
Yes.
And they didn't mind that you were taking drugs?
You don't seem to understand. They're not drugs, they're curative procedures for top international agents, which is what they use, hashish and marijuana.
What do they cure you of?
What do they cure us of? Malaise. Pedantry. Primarily pedantry is the main thing they cure. The thing they work the best on is ease of mind, less worry, relaxing. Which one there is that much on schedule before you, it's difficult to do without agents of some substance or another.
What do you mean, pedantry? Is that something you can see?
Economic pedantry.
I'm not familiar with that word at all.
Economic pedantry, that's severe pedantry.
What is pedantry?
Pedantry is pain, exertion, anxiety with no loving care, no. And the best cure for that is rest, relaxation, and marijuana, and hashish, and woman. Woman used to be the only known cure for pedantry, and in some cases, severe pedantry. But hashish is really the main cure, or the main stepping stone. But to remove the things that they prevent from the next time, those will have to be satisfied, along with the cure.
What kinds of things did you do in intelligence besides killing people?
Tracking, coding, filing.
Okay. Do the people in intelligence know that you're here?
Beg your pardon?
Do the people in intelligence, your superiors, know that?
You certainly do, yes.
Why haven't they?
That was a reply from them right then. That is incorrect, and yes, ma'am, if you wish, then that is what you may do.
Oh, you can hear them?
No. Read the copy prints.
Where?
Yes, sir, we do believe she was just about ready to come to that realization, but she's not so certain herself, and that'd be said in another second that she would appear to prove that. That was in that one second verse there.
What can you see? Things coming from my head, or?
No. I can read code levels in the
print? Oh. What is a comp print? Some kind of computer printout or something?
Those particular lights, that they're not necessarily a code printout, but they're human-based.
So you get them from lights? Where do you see them?
Big part.
Where do you see the comp prints?
Behind me. In front of me.
Just out in the air?
The light switches and move. Yeah. Yes, but you must be able to read and decipher them. I've been trained all my life to read them. I am the best. I am the highest IQ. I am the best reader and the best leader in the comp forces.
What does the comp stand for?
Comp. Compliance. Yes. Well, it's broken down into absolute basics, but it's an intelligence world. And a comp base is a comp base is where men work together to decide what exactly they have to go in certain areas.
How did the intelligence people?
And that's 1990 comp right there.
1990, what do you mean?
Yes, that's where I just came from. They were able to trace and decipher more out from there three times.
You're in 1983, right?
That's 83 right there, and it's 84.
So you know the future?
Yeah, that's 90.
You've been in the future?
Yes, and in fact, that's where I just came from not more than 2 weeks ago.
Why did they transport? transport you back to the past?
Because that part of Armageddon was reaching a certain particular point, we were no longer needed. So we had to go to the past.
So, what did you do in the past? What was your mission in the past?
Run supplies, detect enemy agents, aid those who are wounded and in need of help, and bring prayer thoughts in the past. There are certain messages spelled out through the universe.
And what are you going to do next? What's in the future?
Well, if you're up. After I crawl off the cross, it's going to be pretty fine, you know.
You're going to go on a cross?
Yes.
How's that?
I'm heading for the first John the Baptist.
Yeah. What do you mean?
I want to die on the cross beside Jesus. Only he didn't die there.
You are that same person?
I am the same person.
Or are you going to do that again?
I'm going to do that for the first time. I haven't got there yet.
Oh, you're going to go back in time?
Yes.
In time. What's the purpose of that?
The purpose of that? Well, it has a number of different purposes. But other than a tribute to those who are living and guaranteed to their lives, no, because infiltration among the mortal people was heavy for a while. And there are proofs that we are going through since changing. And that we are suffering as they are. So just bear with it and bear your torment. And if you can't help someone, this is what it means from our side. And we're also telling the bad, which is like they're newly created, such as all the demons and devils and everything, which is that they are proof that they are not the only ones that are doing this, you know? And to stay away, except in certain circumstances.
Are you a very religious person?
I am a Lord God, Jehovah.
You are God?
Yes, I am. I'm the head of my entire race.
Have you been having any trouble sleeping lately?
No.
Have you had any trouble getting to sleep or with waking up very early?
That is where it is, waking up early.
You wake up early?
Yes.
How early?
Incredibly early. Oakdale was about the worst thing it was.
What was Oakdale?
Oakdale was where I underwent torture and wrecking procedures for a long time.
What kind of procedures inside?
Wrecking. That's when, like, your brain and your body reach a certain extent, you know? That mind sort of rebels in the colorful display of lighting, which is sometimes red, sometimes light gray, sometimes light blue, and particularly white. That's known as back. And when God gets so much pressure on him, then he backs, which fills the entire body, which doesn't do much for the pedantry.
Is pedantry somehow associated with your hands?
Well, I can feel it. Here. See? That's pedantry, that's checking. It's shortened up a bit now, which is how they try to cure it, which is dispersing it as much as possible throughout my body, which means it needs to be fed immediately.
Do you ever have the feeling that all of a sudden some alien forces withdraw all the thoughts from your head?
That has occurred once or twice, yes.
Who? Is that the enemy again that does that?
It certainly is.
How do you explain that they're able to do that?
Because according to the laws, since they were created, which was deficient of a normal life expectancy, that they are permitted to attack the Lord God whose fault it was in the first place. Which is what gets them hell in hurry and on the other side when they are not involved anymore. In between that, fear and frustration, and until it comes to something like that, they don't even wait. They just sink a band and it goes in the very center of my being. And is encompassed where it is not speaking anymore.
And it comes back again later?
Yes. They know how to operate machinery as well as man.
Do you ever hear voices that other people can't hear?
Voices that other people can't hear. Seems that way, yes.
Do you hear them inside of your head, or do you hear them with your ears as if they were in the room? And what kinds of things do they say to you?
It's mostly in mind that they speak.
What do they say?
I don't know, just torment you. Just that what I did caused such and such a disaster here, and that what I did caused such and such a disaster there.
Whose voices are they, do you think?
I'm not sure.
Are they men's or women's voices?
Both. Men's, women's, and children. By the way, I hope you're through.
Why's that?
Because I'm getting tired of saying things that you already know.
But I don't already know these things.
I'd like to call a halt to this if possible and get back to it another day.